Hello, friends. Rita Lawrence and I am back with Chapter 12, a review of The Science of Getting Rich. And oftentimes I will read this book and I'll do my, I got my hot tea, I will do my research and reading at night. And then I'll come on the next day after I kind of sleep on it, meditate on it. But to be honest, I've been reading Chapter 12 now for, I don't know, it's been a little while, probably 3 or 4 times. And you know, I was just inspired to come right on tonight and give you some goodies here. So first of all, with this book, you know, this is not a new book, right? It is something that has been brought back into the world here in more recent times. For instance, Think and Grow Rich came from this book. Rhonda Byrne, she made the movie The Secret, right? This was the book she talked about in the beginning of that movie. That her sister gave her. She was going through a rough time. And yeah, so it's brought so many miracles to so many lives, and it's really, really brought lots to mine too. So that was one of the main reasons I decided to share all this with you, because it is changing my life in really big ways, and I want it to change your life too. And I hope that it does. And I hope that you're open to that. So what I'd love to do is, you know, this is not a part of this. You don't have to, you know, be researching philosophical theories and that kind of stuff, but I enjoy doing that. I love looking at the history. I love researching and reading about different philosophies and theories, and it's just like, it lights me up. I mean, history was one of my favorite classes in school. I got straight hundreds, straight A's all the time, history. I just loved reading about our history and where we, as a human race and as humanity, where we came from, and you know, what kind of resources and, you know, what everybody used, right? So one of the philosophers that contributed, you know, some theories and his information to this, to Wallace Wattles, which is the author of Science of Getting Rich, was a German philosopher. I think he was German philosopher, Hegel. So then I start researching Hegel, right? And I start reading all about what he did and where he got his, you know, wisdom and knowledge from. And it turned out he actually would read a lot. He read and read and read. It just reminds me of myself, because I've always loved to read. I've literally been a reader and a book reviewer since like the first grade. So it's something that really, that I just love to do. So I'm grateful to be here doing it with you. So anyway, he read nonstop from poets, and I had to write this name down because I couldn't remember the name, but Klopstock is a name, German. I know, interesting thing too, because a lot of my history is German. So it really interests me to read all of this. So he was associated with the Age of Enlightenment. He was a poet that was associated with the Age of Enlightenment. So, you know, if you don't already know, Ben Franklin, Thomas Jefferson. So Thomas Jefferson actually contributed a lot of the ideals of the Age of Enlightenment in his work into the Declaration of Independence. Can you believe that? And then after that, Madison actually incorporated some of these ideals into the U.S. Constitution. I mean, how freaking amazing is that? I just think that's amazing that when you look back and back and back in history, and you know, I mean, really one of the things that inspires me to do that is because I see so much success coming from those that really grasp these principles and apply them to their lives. So here's the deal though, you don't have to get it all. You don't have to spend time, you know, late into the night like I do, you know, reading all of this and doing all this. If you just grasp one or two of the major principles from this book, massive success. And it's simple. It's not something that's difficult to do. These are simple principles, but this chapter is called Efficient, I'm spitting, I'm getting excited, Efficient Action. So here's the deal. You know, these aren't principles that you can just do every now and then. These are principles that for a period of time, you have got to make a full-on commitment to apply them and put them into practice in your life, because that's the only way then that you'll see the compound effect, right? The only way that it can build and that you'll see the growth in yourself and in your riches, you know, whatever riches are to you. I'll start with one of the quotes that Emerson, I'm gonna look and see, Deming. It's not good enough to do your best. You have to know what to do first. Or, I added this, you'll continue to struggle, right? Some of us feel like we're doing our best. For years, you know, I put time and effort into building my network marketing company. And it wasn't efficient action because I didn't know exactly what to do. I wasn't following a recipe. I was following little pieces of what everybody was giving me in my company. And so there, you know, I still saw growth, but it was slow. Very, very slow. And thankfully I stuck with it because now that I have a recipe and now that I have this efficient action that I can take, growth is happening in a much different way and seamlessly. There's no struggle, and it's much easier. So efficient action is important. And I'm gonna read you, we're gonna start with an actual quote here now from this chapter. Every act can be made strong and efficient by holding your vision while you're doing it and putting the whole power of your faith and purpose into it. So we've got to, and we've covered this in previous chapters, we've got to have a good grasp of our faith, unwavering faith, and then also know our purpose, right? Have that vision of our purpose. And then you've got to be larger than your current situation or position. Like say we're talking about work. You've got to give more than what your boss expects of you. You've got to give more value, and we've gone through this before, but I'm gonna recap this, than you're getting paid for. You've got to overfill your place, or you will never be enough to fill the higher level, right? The next level, whatever that next level is to you, going above and beyond, going the extra mile. You know, there's a quote, and it's it says, the extra mile is never crowded. And it's so true. You look around, and most people are, you know, just getting by. They're just doing enough. And I'm not saying that I've not been there. You know, to this day, I still ask myself every day, am I giving all I can right now? Am I giving the extra, am I going the extra mile? To remind myself and to make sure to keep me in check, because it is a daily journey. This is not something that, you know, we arrive anywhere at any point. It's a continuing compounding effect every day as we put these principles into action. And I thought this was very powerful too. So listen to this. Those who do not quite fill their present places are dead weight upon society, government, commerce, and industry. They must be carried along by others at a great expense. The progress of the world is retarded only by those who do not fill their places they are holding. They belong to a former age and a lower stage or plane of life, and their tendency is toward degeneration. So you're either growing or you're dying. You know, you're either filling your place or you're not. You're either lifting the world and all of the things in your life, or you're weighing them down, or they're being weighed down. So you've got to choose, you know, what actions you're gonna take every day, and will they be efficient? So how do we make them efficient? You know, you can look around and see some examples of those that have made efficient action. Like for instance, Michael Phelps, okay. He actually had won, it was over, I know it was 23 gold medals, but I think altogether was 28 by the time he retired. And, you know, when it showed a picture of him in his race, I think it was the last big Olympic race that he did. So he got first place, right? And it showed a picture of him next to his second place, you know, the one that came in second place, right? And Michael Phelps was like, beeline. He had his blinders on and he was heading for the win. But number two was looking at Michael Phelps. So that's one thing that Michael Phelps' coach actually said in an interview, that he was not focused on competing. He was not focused on his competition, but he focused on just getting better every day. It reminds me of the quote or the word Kaizen. And my mentor, Robert Hollis, talks about this all the time. Kaizen is where you're constantly improving every day. I actually think I wrote down exactly what he had said at one point. Getting a little bit better than the day before. So, you know, I mean, we're focusing on 1% better every day. Imagine how many percent better Michael Phelps had to give to make it to the Olympics, right? Consistency. Consistency is very, very important in being efficient, being consistent, and with an attitude of gratitude, being thankful, not complaining about what you're doing or where you'd rather be or what you'd rather be doing, because that totally defeats what you're doing. There's no, you know, moving forward if you're complaining. There's just not. One of the most beautiful things, too, that I read in this chapter, and this really brought a lot of freedom to my life, because I was one of the ones that really had a hard time focusing and celebrating my success, you know, my wins. In our coaching calls with Melody, one of the things that we always do is they ask in Six Figure Mastery, is they ask us to share a win on every call. And, you know, I never did that before for myself. I never celebrated my wins. So in my mind, every day was a failure because I would only be focusing on what I didn't do, you know, what didn't get done. And here's what this chapter really, really puts out there is every day is either a successful day or a day of failure. It's one or the other. You can't have a day of success and a failure. It's going to be one or the other. So I'm now able to look at my actions and celebrate my wins every day and go to bed at night knowing I did all I could. I got 1% better. I put efficient action into my day and into my goals that day. So every night now when I lay my head on my pillow, I can be so at peace and content knowing that I am a success and that there is no failure as long as I continue to move forward and as long as I don't stop and give up. Just beautiful. If you're moving forward that day, count your success, not what you didn't do, right? Do every day all that you can do that day. And here's the thing though, only the things that matter. You know, don't go around your day just doing random haphazard actions all day long and not seeing the results that you're looking for. That is one thing too. I think it was another Deming quote that Robert Hollis mentioned when he did this book review, and his is called Mastering the Science of Getting Rich. And it's awesome. And if you haven't watched his yet, you absolutely need to go watch his as well. And it is in the files section, actually in this group. You can download it and take a look because he's got a lot of wisdom that, you know, come from a completely different perspective. And that's what's beautiful about this and about our, you know, community of people that are growing themselves and that are doing, you know, diving into this book. Everybody comes from a different perspective, right? We're all different human beings and we all have a different way of explaining. We all have different personal experiences to bring to the table. You know, I buy as many of these reviews as I can from people because I want to know everybody's point of view. I want to know what their personal experiences were and what their successes are from this. And it inspires me and it gives me growth. And I recommend you do the same. So here's another sentence that really spoke to me. You're not to overwork nor to rush blindly. So, you know, you think of a weight loss journey, right? So there's this big goal at the end, right? Or usually that's the perception that there's going to be an end to the journey, which my weight loss journey, I realized the journey was the destination. There was no end. But you think of that. So you think of how people lose weight, right? Okay, some people just rush right in and they literally stop eating. Or they go to the gym like 2 or 3 times a day, right? Sorry, I need a little drink. Chamomile tea. And, you know, for how long is that maintainable? For how long are those actions manageable on a day-to-day basis? Is it efficient? No, it's not. But because they want it so bad and they just want to have results right away and they don't want to be patient and they don't want to be consistent and they don't want to take it day by day, the only way that makes it efficient, they get themselves into either health issues or, you know, a whole host of things goes wrong with our bodies and our metabolism when we do that to ourselves. So, you know, you can think of growing your business or growing your relationship in the same way. It takes time. It takes consistent action. Say, you know, this reminds me of you know, areas in my relationships that I've had where one of us or the other has made a mistake, and then we need to work on building our trust back, right? We need to work on helping the other person remember what it was in us that they loved in the first place, right? After we made a mistake. If you've ever cheated on somebody, you know what I'm talking about here. That takes time. And here's where divorce is really high, because most people aren't interested in that. They're not interested in, you know, recommitting, taking the time to build that trust again, giving 100% of themselves to that person again, being transparent in everything they do, keeping their phone unlocked, keeping their computer unlocked, so that they can build that trust again. And it's vital to save the relationship and to save the love. In the business, you know, I think about my network marketing business. Again, it's taken years to build that. It's taken years. You know, I started out, I'd get paid monthly, which was awesome, but my goal was to get paid weekly. And then as I continued to be consistent, little by little, day by day, then I started getting paid bi-weekly. Now I get paid weekly, sometimes daily, but my goal for this year is to have consistent daily pay. And, you know, I'm working on that now, but here's the thing. I've had to put in time. I've had to be consistent. I've had to commit. I've had to commit and not quit and turn my back. And as I've been on this personal growth journey, especially here recently, you know, seeing my results increasing and seeing the efficiency that I've gained from this program and Melody's accountability program really just inspires me to just keep on going even more, to just keep on going, to keep reading this book, to keep reading and doing all of my daily efficient actions, you know, every day, and not to give up. And that's where, you know, most people just don't do that. You know, that's why most people don't make it in network marketing, because they're not willing to put the time and energy in to see the results. So, you know, you choose. You don't have to succeed. You don't have to see the results. You don't have to succeed at your marriage. You don't have to. It's a choice. Everything is a choice, and we choose, you know, what we put a priority on. Here's another statement. It is really not the number of things you do, but the efficiency of each separate action that counts. Thinking of your results, being grateful, putting all of your energy into it, right? When I'm connecting on Facebook or on any social media, or even out in town at a party, at a community function, at a fundraiser, I put my whole heart into that. I don't check my phone messages and check my emails at the same time. When I take my daughter on a date, or when I go on a date with my husband, I don't work on social media or check my emails at the same time. It's important to put the, you know, efficient, focused intention into what we're doing. It's very important. Also, to be excited. I mean, that's part of being efficient, is having that excitement that's going to carry you through. Having that excitement that when challenges and struggles come, you won't quit, because you are so freaking excited to get to that next step, to get to that next level. And that takes continually refocusing, reprioritizing, and making sure that our purpose is at the forefront of our mind, of our heart, and of our spirit. Every day, remembering our purpose will keep us committed. You know, in my marriage, we've both made mistakes. I'm on my third marriage, for goodness sakes. I finally realized nobody's perfect. And that, you know, I had to do a lot of work on myself to really bring in a long-term commitment. And as I've done that, I have found the beauty of a long-term marriage, where I did not have that before. I didn't grow up in that. It's all I ever wanted growing up, though. It's all I dreamed of when I was a kid. You know, the typical all-American family, mom, dad, siblings, and a pet. And I never had that growing up. So that was one of my big goals as an adult and as, you know, a woman, was to have and grow and nourish a healthy family and to do whatever it took to do make that happen and to do that and to be that, to do whatever it took to continually be committed to my husband, to continually be committed to caring for my children, no matter how much energy and time and whatever it took, I'm committed. And that's why we're here 15 years later, through, you know, failures and humanness of our mistakes that we've made. You know, we are totally open and honest with each other about everything. Everything. And until you can be transparent like that with another human being that you're living with and be that open and be that much of a friend, you know, that's what brings long-term commitment and marriage and happy families. I truly believe that. I mean, obviously, after everything I've been through, I have a little bit of experience. So, what's the next piece? I wrote down a quote from J. Paul Getty. He's one of the, you know, biggest multi-billionaires on the planet. And he says, it's so easy to be successful because nobody else is trying. So, you know, it's really important that when you're taking action every day, that you're not just following actions that somebody else is taking that is not documented. You've got to make sure that they've received and achieved the level of success that you're looking for. You know, if you want to make $1,000 a month, you need to be learning from somebody that's making $1,000 a month. Hey, I can help you do that. But if you're looking for somebody that's making $10,000, if you want to make $10,000 a month, $100,000 a month, that's above my, you know, qualifications. You need to look for somebody at this time anyway. You need to look for a mentor that's doing that. Robert Hollis, Melody Riba. You know, learn from a documented mentor. And if you haven't considered hiring a mentor, I would like to know why. Because, you know, my level of success I'm at, I never would have gotten here in any area of my life. In my portrait business that I owned for 10 years, the only reason I achieved the success of earning six figures a year when it came to my portrait business was I hired a coach. I hired photographers that were there making six figures a year and beyond to teach me and to make sure that, you know, my business skills were on par and that my photography skills were on par. And then I continued to be creative and unique, and I continued to, you know, focus on my own creativity. Again, that certain way, you know, not being competitive the way many, many are. There is enough for everyone. There is enough, friends. Be consistent. Don't be competitive. Be creative. You know, if I can build a network marketing company with three kids, you know, when I started out in working online, you know, switching from my portrait business, which is a very hands-on, very time-consuming. Owning your own business, guys, it's not all it's all cracked up to be. Believe me, if you've never owned your own business, it's very easy for your business to begin to own you. But because you're doing what you love, you know that quote, if you do what you love, you'll never work a day in your life. Well, I have to say, that's not 100% true. Because what happens is you realize that, you know, to build and to grow, you've got to do more work. I had to take more sessions to make more money. You know, when I got to $12,000, $15,000 a month, I was working my butt off. I was killing, literally, I gained a lot of physical issues because of all of the hours I put into my work. So, learn from other people's mistakes. Slow and steady wins the race. You know, this chapter really brought that to my mind, and my mentor actually covers that in his chapter, but what was interesting is I had already pulled up that story on my iPad, and then I listened to his review, and he talked about it. So I was like, whoo, this is confirmation. I need to share this. You know, you want to think of yourself when it comes to whatever you're doing in this situation, with being efficient and in not overdoing it one day and underdoing it the next day, you know, in your consistency, is is focusing on doing what you can every day and being consistent where you are, right? Turtles are very slow, hares are very fast, but because of the difference in their mindset, who won the race? I think we know. I don't think I have to go into that. You know, you think of babies, right? I've had three of them. And how do they learn how to walk? Slowly, one day at a time, and with lots of tumbles and falls and, you know, bruises and bumps and busted mouths. I think all of my kids have, you know, fallen while they were learning to walk. So it's important to remember this is not a journey of perfection. You know, it's not a personal perfection journey. It's a personal growth journey. And, you know, in a job, you can be whatever you want to be. You can be at any level of personal growth you want and still get a job. But when it comes to relationships, when it comes to network marketing, building your own business, you've got to be before you can do and have success. You've got to be first and be consistent with your actions and being efficient on your journey. Let's see, I wanna make sure I covered all the concepts and ideas. Yeah, okay, so I wanna read you the end of this chapter because I don't know that I've done that yet. And it's a beautiful, you know, when I first started reading this also, I will let you know that, you know, I didn't understand it all. I didn't get it. It's not something that you read for the first time or that you hear and you're like, oh yeah, I mean, maybe. You know, if you've been on a personal growth journey and you've been reading, I mean, I have been on a long personal growth journey, I'll admit. I've always been drawn to self-help books and, you know, growth books. I do love reading fiction, but not as much. I love reality. I've always been that way. So you never know. Everybody's at a different level. So when everybody reads this, you get something different or you don't get it all the time. So I'll read this and I just want you to be okay with that. You know, if you don't get it all the first time, it's like reading the Bible. You're not going to get it all the first time. There's way too much there for you. I mean, the ideals and the philosophies that this book includes, you know, the principles are simple, but I have to admit, it's pretty deep. It's pretty deep. So let me read you a few of these paragraphs super quick here before we end. There is a thinking stuff from which all things are made and which in its original state permeates, penetrates, and fills the